If RPC has to be a viable mechanism for structuring operating system services above the kernel using the client-server paradigm, then it is important to reduce this overhead. Now let's see how we can reduce the overheads and make RPC cheap enough that you want to use it in building client-server systems. How do we remove these overheads? The trick is to optimize the common case. Now, what is the common case? Well, the common case is the actual calls that are being made by the client to the server. We expect that those calls are going to be made several times during the lifetime of the server and the client. And so that's the key thing, that you want to make sure that during the actual calls, the copying overhead that I talked about and the locality of the arguments and the results in terms of stuff being in the caches that are accessible to the client and the server, that's the key. That's the common case. That's what we want to make as efficient as possible. Now, setting up the relationship between the client and the server itself on the very first call by the client, that needs to be done exactly once. And that process is what is called binding the client to the server. That is done once. The first call is when that binding happens, and that's done once. Now, since the setup or the binding is done only once, it's a one-time cost. It's okay if it is more expensive than the actual calls. So the binding, we can afford to make it more time-consuming. It's okay to do that. And these ideas are should sound very familiar to you from exokernel that we've discussed before, that we want to make the one-time costs not focus on the cost of setting up, which is a one-time cost, but focus on the recurring cost, which is the actual calls that are being made. So now let's discuss in more detail how this binding works. The server has an entry point procedure called foo that it wants to make it available for clients to call. And in order to make it available for everybody, it publishes this entry point procedure in a name server and lets the kernel know that there is an entry point procedure called foo that's available for it. And the name server is a vehicle by which anyone in the system can find out. It's sort of like the yellow pages, right? So you want to look up somebody's name or phone number, you look it up in the yellow pages. So similarly, the name server serves the same purpose, that if I want to know what services are offered as a client, if I want to know what services are offered by a particular server, I can find out from the name server what are the entry point services available from S. So foo is an entry point service that's available in the server, registers the name server, and lets the kernel know that it has this particular entry point. And at this point, the server is basically waiting for bind requests to come from the kernel. Now the client looks up the name server and finds that S is an entry point called foo. So this is an entry point that's available for this client to make a call on the server. So the client issues this call, s.foo, meaning that it wants to execute this procedure foo on the server S. And so that's the RPC call the first time C is making. And this, of course, results in a trap into the kernel. The kernel doesn't know whether the server is willing to accept calls from this client or not. And therefore, what it has to do is it has to check with the server whether there's a legitimate bona fide client that can make calls on this entry point procedure foo. And so the kernel basically makes an up call into the server saying that, hey, you know what, there is this client that wants to make, this identity wants to make a call on your entry point procedure foo, and that's the up call that goes into the server. The server, if it recognizes that this client is a bona fide client that can make this call, it grants permission via the kernel that this client can make this call on its entry point procedure foo. So once this validation has been done, what the kernel does is to set up a descriptor called the procedure descriptor. And this procedure descriptor is a data structure that is in the kernel, and it is for this particular entry point procedure foo. And as part of granting access to the client to make this call into its entry point procedure foo, what the server is going to do is tell the kernel that these are the characteristics of this particular entry point procedure. In particular, it's going to say, this is the entry point address where you have to call me if there is a call. This is the address of the entry point procedure in my address space where code exists for for this particular procedure foo. And this is indicating the size of an argument stack. Now, I'm going to talk to you a little bit more about this in a minute. And this argument stack is going to be the communication area between the client and the server. And this entry in the procedure descriptor is just saying, what is the size of this argument stack? So this communication vehicle that is going to be established between the client and the server is going to be dependent on the formal parameters that are being passed between the client and the server and the results that are being passed from the server back to the client. Based on that, the server is going to indicate to the kernel that, you know what, the communication area that I want is this size. So that's the size of this A stack. And I'm going to talk to you more about that in a minute. And it is also going to say how many simultaneous calls S is willing to accept for this particular procedure foo. And the purpose of this is if this is a multiprocessor and there are multiple cores or multiple processors available, then it may be possible for S to farm out multiple threads to execute simultaneous calls that are coming in from multiple clients distributed in the system. And so this is saying how many concurrent calls the server is willing to accept on behalf of this particular procedure foo. So this procedure descriptor is specific to this procedure foo, and it is saying, where is the entry point in the server's domain for this particular procedure? What is the size of the communication buffer that is needed to be established by the kernel for communication between the client and the server? And the third thing is how many simultaneous calls the server is willing to accept for this particular procedure foo.